Hi everyone, it's Crusail, and I'm here with a little bit of Rogue Heroes Ruins of Tasos. My fellow Tundra Terra Hammy introduced this game to me and the rest of the clan. It's a little bit of Legend of Zelda, mixed with some roguelike functions, reincarnation sort of formulation, and a lot of co-op for dungeon delving. It's also a little bit of, I guess you'd say, Stardew Valley, because there's an aspect of rebuilding and upgrading your town, your homestead. So yeah, I thought I'd give it a go and share it with all of you. So here we go. It will be online co-op when the game actually comes out. Right now it's just single co-op. Let's see here. Cool color to choose from. Let's go with Aqua. Icon. They don't have a shield. Because I tend to play support. Let's try and go with something a bit closer to my actual appearance. Cloak color. Let's go for a deep green. All right. Okay. Fun times. Guess so. All right. Do that to move around. That's how you throw. I like that there's a stamina system. That's interesting. Ouch. Rat tail. Interesting. All right. Kind of, I like the graphic style has a little bit of an Adventure Time feel to it. I'm definitely losing HP more than I would like. There we go. All right. That's how you do it. There we go. Oh. Classic slime mechanics. Okay. Now that's silly of me. There we go. Some bone shards. Oh, okay. There we go. Okinasai. Interesting. So you have to unlock different ones. So I'll probably go for Reaper, actually, because that will allow me to be a more of a healer, I bet. Additionally... not a mage. Maybe a witch. If I'm gonna be the support guy in the crew. Alright. Let's do it. Terrakar Keep. All right. Okay. Interesting. I'm guessing I have to actually unlock the transport nexus. Acorn! Okay. He said head east, right? Yeah, I'm pretty sure he said east. Right. Okay. So I can't fully tell if this is going to be a roguelike or a souls-like, because I don't really know if you keep your stuff and you just have to regain your currency if you die. Oh boy. The OCD is real with this game. That? Oh, it was mana. Rildon Ravine. Interesting. So actually, I guess it's less like, I don't know, because honestly, I haven't seen as much of Stardew Valley as I have of Animal Crossing, but it has sort of the Animal Crossing vibe too, of having to build up a town, but also you've got all these adventures you're able to go on. Ouch. Okay. Just keep heading north to Terrakar, I guess. Woo! Woo, buddy. You guys are quick. Alright. Acorn! Yeah, no. Cow. Or ox? Yeah, I don't know. Looks like a monster yak. Ouch. That's what I'm talking about. Alright. Interesting that you also get ranks in different things like that, like Bushwhacker. I don't know if that will end up unlocking new skills or not, but that's interesting that it tracks different actions you take in the game. Hmm. I'm curious to see what happens if you actually get enough experience to get that. Yeah. Whack 200 bushes. Oh boy. Y'all are gonna hate me by the end of this episode. Just nothing but bushwhacking. Ambrose Lake. Oh, hello. Mamos Farm, huh? Interesting. Hmm. A lot of HP there. Nice. Alright, there is short range tractor beam effects on, or short range tractor effects on this. 120 out of 200 bushes whacked. Okay. Quests. Okay. I'm headed in the right direction, that's good. Wow, that is an expansive map. I should head back north. Oh, really? Okay. Here we go, Terra Car Path. I wonder if there's a way to max you or upgrade your stamina. Ah. Terracar Warp Statue. Alright. But now that it's been discovered, I guess it's active. Does it tell you? Monster drops key items. Okay. It doesn't actually tell you if you've completed one of the missions. Okay. Can't tell if that actually does anything or not. Okay. Ooh. Okay, gotta watch out for the splatter. Yay! Hmm. Well, sadly, it looks like I can't get to that stuff. Well, I think I just got all the gems I needed. Huh. Only one way to go, then. Weird. Oh, I get it. Oh, nope. Wrong button again. There we go. All right. Nope. Oh. Need a bottle for that, huh? Let's get that map. All right. There we go. Okay, so I do need to actually activate them all within a certain time frame, but it is pretty forgiving. How do I... There we go. Ah, that's what I needed. HP boost there. Ouch. I knew I was going to mess that up at some point. Okay. Nice. I haven't found the key yet, have I? Oh, I did. When did I do that? Ow. What the? Oh, mimic. Mimic bad. Mimic bad. Mimic very bad. Ay, ay, ay. There we go. Ah, there we go. Whoa. Freaking snake. Now how do I... Aha. There we go. There we go. saw you shaking that time.
Get dip.
Okay. $34 coins for that one. Okay. Kinda wishing I could up my HP a little bit more, because I feel like I'm getting closer to the boss. Oh man. Oh, short by that much? That's a little insulting. There we go. There we go. Of course. Ugh, what a waste of HP. Huh. Wasn't that interesting? Oh man. Oh. Ouch. Oh, thank goodness. Nice. Oh boy. Oh, these stupid pot snakes. Hmm. That was close. Ugh, of course I managed to do that. Alright, move any of that? Nope. I don't really get the point of those shiny panels at the bottom. Freaking pot snakes! Always getting up in my grill. Whoops. Okay. Nothing there. Only way, one way to go, and that is up. Ugh. Or you could do that. I missed. I want to go back quickly and check that one. That one room that I didn't go into. Whoop, 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 whoop. Forgot about the pitfalls. Oh boy. Ow. Nice. Whew. All right. One more to go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Aha. Victory. Nice. Okay. Only one way to go, and that is back. Alright. Wow, why is it so bright in here? Ah, darn it, every time. Okay. Looks like it's best to go clockwise in this regard. There we go. Is there a sweet spot on my sword that does more damage? Because it looked like some took two hits and other. Oh, actually, it's probably based on their level as well. Yeah, there are monster levels. Come on. Gotta get better about actually managing the space between me and the enemy. There we go. Snakes! Why did it have to be snakes? I hate snakes. I hate them. Kite like a madman. Whew. I hate snakes. I'm pretty sure I actually do have a snake phobia. In real life, it's not the snake's fault, I always get the willies. So close to a clean run. Oh well. Okay, I think that's everything. Oh, ow! Freaking snake! Every time with a snake. Ooh! Yay, I got bombs. Ow. Huh. Ugh. Okay, I see it now. Whew. Glad they felt like sharing that. Goodness. Oh, hey. Snakes. There we go. Alright, down we go. I'm not really sure how far down this goes. I'm hoping, everybody, that this will be a longer episode where I just defeat Terrakar Keep and then go back and show you what happens when you build up Griff's shop. Freaking snake! Really don't like snakes. There we go. Okay. Even when I'm being careful, the snake still gets me. That's a strong one, too. Jeez. Do I have it? Yeah. Okay. Gotta remember I can shield too, that's the other thing. No? Nope, nope, nope. Wanted to go down this way. Up here. What's this do? Okay. Don't have 30 coins yet. Okay. Okay. See what happens if I hit that. Okay. Resets the dungeon. I could place it down gently. Only those can be moved as well. Not really sure what that thing does, the little inflaty thing. I guess I could just proceed forward for now. This might be the end of it for me, folks. There it goes. Whoopsie. Huh. Interesting. Very interesting. Huh. All right, let's do it. Level 3. Hey, Griff. Okay. Can't upgrade the home yet. Interesting, you get to place them where you want them to go. I like that. Let's have the keep near the center of town, or the clinic near the center of town. Inventory clinic. Forge. So I guess he can't go there. Interesting. Let's have it up there. Let's go take a look at this. Hey, kiddo. Hi. Interesting. Very interesting. That's pretty nice. Well, let's make sure that I actually have enough to upgrade my weapon. Oh, wow. Thank you. boost to sword reach. Very interesting. All right. Well, everybody, let's take a quick look at this. Okay. All right. Well, everybody, I actually think that is a very good time to wrap up this little preview of Rogue Heroes. As you can see, it's a charming, fun, overhead adventure game, very Zelda-esque. Got a few things that are reminiscent of Animal Crossing. Gonna have to figure out how to save, though, because I don't really want to have to do all that stuff over again. Oh. It is what it is. Yes, next... if you like this series and you're following what we're doing on the channel a bit more, please let me know if you'd like to see this series continue. I'd be happy to play through the demo a bit more on stream, but I think, or on for episodes, but I honestly think that I will just say that this looks like a very fun game. You can definitely get into it. I feel like I just didn't even realize that almost an hour had already gone by. And yeah, if you like it, check it out. It's only $20 on the store. The demo is free to play. Or on the eShop. $20 on the eShop for pre-order, I should say. It is currently in development, not ready yet for release, but you can pre-order it already for $19.99. US dollars, I should say. And the demo is expansive, as you've seen. Definitely several hours worth of content out of it, at the least. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you for the next one.